Hello, everybody. Hi. Welcome. Can you hear okay? I can turn the volume up on the microphone. You're good. Okay, thank you. All right, welcome, everybody. Thank you so much for being here with us tonight. This is our first concert at the Ocean City Creek Public Library for the fall season. I guess the meteorological fall season has started. So we're thrilled to be kicking it off with the Fiddle Club of Linwood here under the direction of Dr. May Strange. We love having them here at our library. It's always so much fun. And as you know, tonight they will be highlighting Broadway music. And before we get started, I did pass out some flyers for our OC Reads series program. This is the first program in our series, the concert this evening. This year's book is The Violin Conspiracy by Brendan Slocum. If you haven't read it, definitely check it out. We have lots of copies here at our library, and we have lots of great programs coming up to highlight the themes in the book. So you can see more information on these flyers. We have more copies in the kiosk when you leave. If you have any questions, just let me know, but we hope to see you at those programs as well as at the author talk on November 9th right here in this room. So without further ado, I will turn it over to our wonderful group here this evening, and please help me welcome the Fiddle Club.
Can everybody hear me?
Yes.
So we are doing Broadway and movies from 1904 to 2004. They're all mixed up, so we're going to have some times when it's going to be name that tune. But our first song, and later on I will introduce you to all the musicians that are here. This is a multi-generational group. We have from about 10 years old up to the sweet senior, or the sweet fiddle, that's our senior group. And so our first tune is called Circle of Life. This was part of The Lion King. It was on Broadway in 1994, and it was composed by Elton John. regards to Broadway.
Oh, wow.
And this was from the show called Little Johnny Jones, and the composer was George M. Cohan. Next one is Edelweiss. Israelites. Sound of Music, written in what year? 1959. Rodgers and Hammerstein. They say the golden years of Broadway were 50s and 60s. There were so many really fun shows that came out. We were playing quite a few of them. But this is Edelweiss. Violin and saxophone. Yanni plays violin. He also plays French horn. And Taki plays violin and piano. So they're going to do a song called Summertime, which is from the Porgy and Bess, 1935, George Gershwin.
Thank you.
Amatour's family. The children are all triple lingual. They obviously know English, they know Greek, and they also know Japanese. We're switching gears. We're going to go to Go, 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 Joseph, which is from Joseph and the Amazing Technicolor Dreamcoat. Anybody know the year? 1969, Andrew Lloyd Webber. You were going to guess that? Next time. But there was a remake done in 2006. But my younger students, they never heard of the Pink Panther before. They don't know what they're missing. Anybody know? what year that was from?
68.
It's almost at a
9.
They said it?
I think so.
66?
66. 1966. So you are in the you may be the grand prize composer. And the composer was Kander and Ev was the lyric. Wrote the lyric.
Thank you.
next one is going to be the mystery one. You have to tell me what we're playing. But it's an easy one. I think you should all get it.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Thank you.
church on time. And that was from My Fair Lady. It opened in Broadway in 1964. And it was, it was in 1956. And the composer was Lower.
Thank you.
it was from here to 1941.
From here to eternity.
What was it?
From here to eternity.
No. No. So the name of the movie was Blues in the Night. And it was written by Harold Arlen. So now we're going to do a song about a dream. The Impossible Dream from Man from La Mancha. La Mancha. It's La Mancha?
Yeah, La Mancha.
But it has that N in there, I wasn't sure. 1965 by Leah and Darlin. Now, we have another violinist here who came all the way from California to play in Fiddle Club. Known all across the country. However, she does vacation here in Ocean City. So we're hoping to have her back every summer. Now that she learned about Fiddle Club, we'll always enjoy having her. So this is going to be about two violins for this song. And was written in 1980. The composer was Schoenberg. And actually, I'm sure some of you have heard Susan Boyle sing this one. That's who we sound like.
In my dreams.
Thank you.
my favorites. Now we're going to go 1975, Mamma Mia. And this was written by Anderson, Uolsi, and Anderson. Someday we'll come up here with 76 violins. Now this was from the Music Man. Anybody know what year? It was in the 50s. Now remember the golden years of Broadway, 50s and 60s, 1957. And it was by Meredith Wilson. 1, 2, 1, 2. So that one from 1904 was, anybody remember?
Dr. May.
All that jazz.
I forgot one. And all that jazz.
So, it's from Chicago. It was a movie in 2000 by Kander and Ed. You know, almost every show I skip one. So, I'm not getting used to it now. Making fun of was The Wizard of Oz. So we had to do something from The Wizard of Oz, and we're going to do Over the Rainbow. Now, Wizard of Oz was a movie,
And that was made in, anybody know the year? 1938. Very close. Scarlett on the chair is Joe Giordanato. And Joe buys trains for Amtrak.
Oh!
Different, right? In front of Joe, we've got Rebecca Fermani. We've been so thrilled because we finally have a viola in our group. We've got lots of violins, viola, and cello. And look at, we've expanded our bass section to two. So right, the first one on the bass is Draper Bird. And the next one, I'm going to call him our director of operations. This is Scott Shepherd. He's also my husband. So he's the, he does all the things that I can't do to make Fiddle Club work. And then our cellist sect, we have Kevin Hunter. Kevin's side job is he's a neurologist for AtlantiCare. Oh. Next to Kevin, we have George Plamotoris from the musical family. George has been, not only plays instrument, but teaches languages, and he teaches here at Ocean City High School. Oh. Now, last but not least, we do have Gene Kibler here on keyboard. She has played with me many times. We played together. She's worked with me as a teacher when I had the studio. So we go back quite a long ways, and I can always trust her that it'll come out together, right? No matter what we do. Now I have, and actually Carly also worked with me in the studio for years, and works at the Pleasantville Middle School as a music educator. So I think that's it. So we have one last number, so don't ask for an encore. This is it. And this is There's No Business Like Show Business. Was written in 19... Anybody know?
46.
How do you know? I already told you. 1946. And...
He said you'd win that grand prize.
The name of the show was Annie Gets Your Gun. Oh, yeah. That was an Irvin Berlin film. It was awesome. It was... right. Yeah. Paul in the back. Yes. Everything is for you. So this, There's No Business Like Show Business, became a movie in 1954. Anybody know who starred in that movie?
Judy Garland.
No. Marilyn Monroe. Yeah. I know, she wouldn't have been my pick either, but. Okay, here we go. There's no business like show business.
Thank you.
looks like you enjoyed it. We enjoyed it.
Have a good night.
Thank you.